Situation with the Alaska Assembly. September 5, 2019 by Anna von Reitz. People have asked me why I am not active in the Alaska Assembly. I can't be at this time, because I am anchoring all the claims of the states that entered the Union under the Northwest Ordinance, including my birth state, Wisconsin. Similarly, my husband is anchoring the states that are still in limbo, like Washington State, where he was born, states which were never officially enrolled as members of the Union and are only members of the Federation by compact. Only our sons and daughters who were born and raised in Alaska are able to participate in the Alaska Assembly directly, without harming the legal and lawful claims of other innocent people in other states. And there have been reasons that they have held off too. The former leaders of the incipient group in Fairbanks, never officially part of the American States Assembly, are wonderful people and good Christians, but their religious beliefs led them to want to mix our strictly non-sectarian government with theocracy, and the fact remains that guaranteeing religious freedom for all is the right role for government, even if we are Christians in our private lives. Our government guarantees religious freedom for all, because our forefathers realized that this is the surest way to guarantee religious freedom for ourselves, too. When we leave a door to oppression open, we can be oppressed along with those whose rights we abandoned, like setting a bear trap and forgetting about it. One can become the victim of one's own laxity and oversight. That is what happened with the issue of slavery. We didn't actually close that door to oppression at the end of the Civil War. Southern Democrats in league with European bill collectors and banks contrived to assume the title to the freed plantation slaves so as to use them and their labor and possessions as collateral backing government debt. As a result, the evil of slavery never ended. It simply flip-flopped from private slave ownership to public slave ownership, and we have all suffered as a result, as the perpetrators were further encouraged by their success in re-enslaving Negroes to contrive means to enslave all of us as chattel-backing government debt. We are still resolving the detritus of mistakes and self-interest and fraud left over from the Civil War. Slavery is still an issue for and within this country, because we failed to put an end to it in all jurisdictions. We failed the American Negroes, and that has very nearly led to our enslavement, too. As our forefathers knew, the oppression of one man leads to the oppression of all men. The suppression of one man's religious conscience leads to the suppression of religious conscience as a principle. When we restrict the right to free speech, we gag ourselves. So if we succumb to our religious prejudices and seek to make America into a theocracy, instead of honoring our commitment to freedom of religion, we leave open exactly such a door to oppression and set exactly such a bear trap again. I could not get the Fairbanks leadership to understand that, so the future of the group as a whole and its legitimacy as an assembly was always in doubt. I am happy to report that Alaska has a new state assembly coordinator, and it is not Destry Payne. Destry was the former webmaster for the Michigan General Jural Assembly, a group that almost got it right, but not quite, in that they have not recognized the need to declare their proper political status and organize their state in preparation for organizing a new federal state of state. He moved to Alaska about a year ago and has taken over the group in Fairbanks, which he continues to mislead and to incite to violent action. I wish to make it absolutely and perfectly clear that this group in Fairbanks is not acting in accord with the knowledge that we have, and not following the peaceful and lawful path to assemble an actual state. The Fairbanks group members have not reliably completed and recorded the necessary declarations. The group as a whole is not part of the American States Assembly process. And it is becoming increasingly exhorted, by Destry Payne, to take violent and preemptive action of some undesignated kind. This is par for the course for federal agents. They don't get specific about what action people are supposed to be taking, they just incite action and then let the victims hang themselves, like Sheffer Cox. The federales made him fearful and got him thinking about actions to take in case, and got him to talking about such plans, and that is how they snared him and drummed up enough evidence to charge him. I very much suspect that the same modus operandi is being employed in Fairbanks again, right now, trying to ensnare more innocent people with fear-mongering and contingency plans and more of the same kind of entrapment as was employed before, only this time by an imported agent, Destry Payne, playing a role more similar to that played by Michael R. Hamilton, who misled the Colorado Nine. It is a goal of federal agents to quash organization efforts for our lawful government by such entrapment programs aimed at people naive enough to fall for it. They then make examples of them in hopes that the rest of the population will be too scared to assemble their states. As I am in Alaska, it would be logical for the federales to try to target any group organizing a state assembly here. They would love to be able to take down any group calling itself the Alaska Assembly and blame it on me, and scare off all those who are committed to restoring our lawful government. But I have nothing to do with what is going on in Fairbanks, and neither does the American States Assembly. Even though the group in Fairbanks has never actually qualified to be the Alaska Assembly, and even though they have never officially joined the American States Assembly process, taking them down could be used as a publicity stunt, and the misery inflicted on these innocent people like that already inflicted on Sheffer Cox and the Colorado Nine could be used to throw cold water on all our efforts to get this country back on track. I am therefore making this public statement about all these goings-on, the reasons and why. We now have an Alaska Assembly operating under the American States Assembly process in accord with the actual law. The members are making and recording the proper declarations. My children will join this organization, which upholds the separation of church and state. I will continue my work as fiduciary for the United States of America, will continue to hold the line for Wisconsin and the other ordinance states, and will continue my office as a justice of the peace for the Alaska state. I wish the people in Fairbanks only goodwill and good fortune, but as was necessary with the Colorado Nine, I fear they are on a dangerous and ill-advised path now, and I wish to make that clear for them, and also wish to make a distinction between what they are doing and being led to do, and what the American States Assembly is about. We recognize the fact that our states of the Union require a singular devotion and that only the actual states can legitimately organize state-of-state service organizations that are of, for, and by the American people. We recognize the necessity of declaring our political status. We know and respect the jurisdictional boundaries. We stand for the peaceful and lawful resolution of these long-standing issues left over from the Civil War, the restoration of our lawful government, and the full reconstruction of the federal government we are owed. I dearly hope that the people in Fairbanks recognize the earmarkings of federal operatives and resist any siren song that involves violence, laying aside stockpiles of guns, and similar activities, for they are almost certainly being set up to take such actions, and if they do, they will just as certainly be arrested. And it will have absolutely nothing to do with me or mine or the actual Alaska Assembly now taking shape or the American States Assembly, either, if the Fairbanks group should fail the test and become another victim of federal incitement.